Meanwhile, the hunt is on for the person who blew up a bomb near a busy Israeli bus station today. One person dead, dozens of people hurt, and Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu saying that Israel will act aggressively and wisely. This was the first major bombing in Jerusalem in several years. On the phone, the mayor of Jerusalem, Nir Barkat. Mayor, what's the latest there?
Well, the latest is that in Jerusalem, we're going back to normal life. And naturally, the Israeli security forces are, I believe, will hunt the person and find the root of the terrorist and pursue the maximum under law. And it's very imperative and important for Jerusalem to go back to normal life as fast as possible, which we're doing.
Well, you guys are very good at that, and you've been sadly used to these kind of things. But lately not, and maybe since the building of that wall, these incidents have dramatically been curtailed. What now? What do you do if this is a sign of maybe more increased violence to come?
Well, I think terrorism is a global problem, and if anybody here in Israel, in Jerusalem, we know how to deal with it. It's a local incident, and I believe that when we find the terrorist that is putting death in the most important thing in a city that promotes life, I believe we'll find the roots of it and get things back on track. Israel and the world needs quiet, and we mustn't get the terrorists to have any gains. Zero gains for terrorists. And go back to normal life. It's the best way to deal with terror.
Do you know, has anyone claimed responsibility, Mayor?
Well, there are a few terrorist organizations that praise the terrorists and praise death of innocent people. You know, the people of Jerusalem, I went to see in the hospital. I saw women and children, and I saw people from Africa and from all around the world that lived their quiet life in the city of Jerusalem. And we will continue doing that. We have a beautiful marathon planned for this Friday, the first Jerusalem Marathon, International Marathon. We have over 10,000 runners, and thank God it's going to continue as normal and continue to be as strong and as beautiful as any marathon could be in the world. By the way, I recommend people in the world to come and share and have and enjoy Jerusalem at its best. And I believe come this. Eventually, we have no choice but to overcome this, not only here in Jerusalem, but all over the Western world or throughout the world.
Mayor, what do you think of the Arab League members backing out, some of them just preventing their planes from being involved at all, in the case of the United Arab Emirates, in these coalition no-fly zone attempts over Libya?
Well, the Israeli experience is be very, very consistent and stubborn when you fight terrorism. Pursue people that want to hurt us to the maximum and maintain a sustainable, high quality of life. And when people stutter, eventually they pay a heavy price.
So these Arab League nations that are having second thoughts, I'm thinking in the case of one, the OAE, because of our policy in Bahrain, which seemed like a weird excuse, but do you think that they're getting skittish now, and they don't want to look like they're for and part of attacking Arabs?
I think they're stuttering, and when you stutter, you pay a heavy price eventually because people cannot trust you. You have to have a very consistent and straightforward and honest strategy. And if you swing from side to side, eventually you lose height and you can crash like anything. And it's true for anything in life, in business and in politics and in managing a city or anything you want to do. My recommendation to the Arab world, stick to peace, stick to life, always condemn terror, never let terror have any gains. And if you do that, long term you win.
Mayor Barkat, thank you very much. Be safe.